Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's video, we're diving into how to create a habit tracker inside of Notion. Now this is the second part of the Notion challenge. This is a new series or playlist here on YouTube that essentially gives me a challenge, and then what we'll do is we'll build that in less than 5 minutes to give you an idea of the simplicity of the databases and things like that. Now, recently they've also been producing a lot of templates, so of course you don't necessarily have to build from scratch, but this should give you a good idea of how to apply something if you want to build it totally from scratch. Just before we dive in, guys, a little word from our sponsor this month in May, which is Brain FM. Now, Brain FM is an innovative application that allows you to listen to music designed to help you focus. With a patented AI music engine, Brain FM's app will recommend you the best music to enhance what you're doing already. Brain FM is available on iOS and Android for free and is supported by science to help you to sustain your focus. Now, I've been following Brain FM's work for a while now, and only recently tried it out, and I was very impressed with the range of musical beats they had to keep you focused. I'm a big listener and heavy listener of classical music when I work, the likes of Ludovic and Naldi, and beat-based music on Spotify, so this was naturally a good transition. Now you can try 5 sessions for free today with the link below, so do enjoy all of those. Anyway, guys, thanks so much to Brain FM for sponsoring Keep Productive this month here in May. Okay, so here we are. I've created a brand new page and I will be developing this from scratch. I'm just going to set a timer. Okay, so the timer has started. Let's dive in to the habit tracker. Okay, so what I did here is I think I created a habit tracker, a very basic one that might help you. We'll go through what I actually went about doing during this process. So as you can see, you can't see the habit tracker right now because it's hidden behind what's called a template button. And the reason I created this is because a habit tracker might want to be replicated every single week. So what we did is we went ahead and created a template button so that every time you press that, a fresh one appears. Now, obviously we've created it inside of what's called a table database. So as you can see here, the button title is New Habit Tracker, and I've hidden it below a toggle. And that's really easy to do. All you have to do is press slash toggle and then hide this underneath that. So let's go ahead and see what that actually demonstrates as. So if I press New Habit, should appear as View Below. Now, if you want to do here, you could put, for example, the week. I know many people use the week 15 of 2019. As a tracker, and then what they do is open this one up. Now, if you wanted to up here as well, something I didn't note is you can use the at today. For example, you could put at, you can't do that. You could put at today as a way to track the day. And if you wanted to turn that out of that format, you go to date and format, the date format to day, month, and year. And if you want to see it like that, you can do so. But in this case, we're actually just gonna have it as week 15 of 2019. So you can see here that I've created a simple table and I've spanned it across the first 5 days of the week, because sometimes a lot of people like to keep it just in the weekday habits. So you can see here that you can keep track using checklist items. So for example, if I was like, okay, it's a Thursday today, I actually did my journal entry today, I did my press ups today, and I'm going to do my boxing so I know that it's done. And you can see a full sort of track of that, which is a good way to be able to see it. Now, the way that we did and went about creating those is we went to the this column area and we turned that as a checkbox, but we titled each of these top columns Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. We put the habits down the left-hand side, but you could, if you wanted to, actually have the habits up the top and the days of the week on the left-hand side. And that could be in the row format, because that could be a good way to do it. Now, the reason I was checking this out is because this is a new feature called database templates. And I was actually just curious as if I did it that way, the Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, I could create a new entry per day. But I'll probably do a separate video on that. Now, as you can see, I kept it fairly simple. I was actually looking at just keeping it simple. So what I did is I created a page with all of these. And if I click in to this one, for example, If I was like, okay, I wanted to do this at the end of the week, for example, okay, I boxed Monday, Tuesday, and actually am boxing Thursday. So I can see a full outline of the days that I boxed. And the one thing I can do is an additional thing is go down here and use the percentage unchecked. So I can see 75%. Actually, I'm going to go percentage checked. Okay, 25% completion rate on Mondays. But if I were to see my completion rate for a Thursday, it'd be 75 because I did 3 out of 4 of the items there. So guys, that's a really simple way of doing it. Let me know in the comments whether you have any questions. This is a Notion challenge, so it's going to be really updated soon. And the main reason is because I have more time to spend on Keep Productive. So I will be doing an experiment for the full week. So for example, like, you know, what I used at the start of the week, what tool I built and why I'm using it and how effective it's been, to give you an idea of how it's used in practical situations. But this is really just getting the series out there because I've only done one feature so far. So do stay tuned for more Notion challenges. Let me know in the comments what I should be doing next. I've got a lot of your feedback from last time, so I really appreciate that. Feel free to continue to recommend after seeing this feature.
So as you can imagine, the habit tracker is a useful way to be able to keep track of some habits and routines that you might want to keep a tally of. I know a lot of people are using the combination of a habit tracker and a journal to be able to track those sort of daily and morning journal entries, and then being able to use a little bit of a habit tracker to keep track of what they're working on. I've been sort of toying around with the idea. You may have seen it in my Notion setup that I've got at that area. I actually haven't been fully optimizing it. I've never really been a person that's been using habits much. I use Habitify for quite a while, maybe about 6 months, using it as an application to track habits. But I'm fairly good with my routine, but I know in a couple of weeks' time when when we move house, I know that obviously my habits are gonna change, my routine's gonna change. So I'm obviously gonna be looking and probably look at Notion as a way to keep track of all of them. So do stay tuned. Hopefully I can do a video on that and how that panned out. Thank you very much to Brain FM for sponsoring this month here on Keep Productive. We will be donating $100 to Mind, which is a mental health charity in the UK, and we'll include that at the end of the month. So please do check out the charity below. And if you want to make any direct donations, you can do. So guys, a big thank you, and I will see you guys in the next video. I look forward to having you. Cheers, guys.